طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We'll start inshallah with بلوغ المرام. Now we start another chapter which is about wudu, about wudu, ablution. And here I would like to remind you, it's better for the Muslim to learn the Islamic terms instead of using translation, because sometimes these words, it doesn't in fact reflect the correct meaning. When you say ablution, some people, you know, they recall in their mind certain meanings, which is not as we think it's, you know, relates to their belief or relates to their, you know, previous culture. But when you say wudu, it is for the Muslim, he understand the deep meaning of the word wudu. And I will explain to you why. Because the word by itself, it has a meaning. It has significance. The word itself, it has significance. Subhanallah. So the Muslim try his best to use the Islamic terms. The Islamic terms better than the translation, which is in different language. طيب. So we start inshallah this chapter, which is about wudu. We already talk about removing the najasa, the impurity. We talk about different types of impurity and how to get rid of different types of impurity. And today inshallah we'll start about wudu. As you know, in our class, this book, بلوغ المرام في أدلة الأحكام, because this book depends on hadith. You give the hadith, and from this hadith, you derived what? The rules, al-ahkam. نعم? From, and this is, it's very important. Why? So the Muslim, he knows that any rules that he learned about, in fact, it's based on dalil. Based on dalil, on proof. Either from the Quran or the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Here we are talking about the Sunnah. We talk about the Sunnah. But if there's any verses in the Quran which is related to the subject, will be mentioned. But the book by itself, it's collection of a hadith which relates mostly to what? To rules, that Muslim derives certain rules from these hadith. Also, we learn from this how can we verify the hadith. We know about some of the Sahaba when you talk about their the biography of the narration. We learn also that the way that we derive rule from the hadith, because sometimes some people, they just hear or they learn one hadith and then they go and make they say certain rules, which is not always. We warn against this. Don't just go and take one ayah or one hadith or two or three, and based on this hadith you go and make rule, because there's different hadith. Some hadith or some of the ayah was abrogated with new rules that come after it. You know, the revelation, it took how many years? 23 years. Some of them they were at the beginning, but then came other proofs, other adilla, other hadith, which has changed the rule. So it's not a matter that the person, he just come and take hadith and he make conclusion from that hadith, that the rule like this or like that. This is why we always refer to whom? To the ulama. Refer to the ulama, because the ulama, they have comprehensive inshallah knowledge, and they spend all their life studying and verifying different hadith and different dalil, and they give us what? The conclusion. طيب. Start with this hadith. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال لولا أن أشق على أمتي لأمرتهم بالسواك مع كل وضوء. طيب, This hadith was reported by Imam Malik, wal Imam Ahmad, wal Imam An-Nasa'i, wa sahahahu Ibn Khuzaymah, and wa dhakarahu al-Bukhari ta'liqan. Ta'liqan. طيب, the meaning of this hadith, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if it were not too much of burden on my nation, my ummah, my followers, I would have ordered them to use the siwak with every ablution. That means any time they perform ablution, they use siwak. The siwak. Now let's go to this hadith. But first of all, let's look at the word wudu. Wudu from wada, wada'a, which is writing and lighting. Why? Because the wudu, it's like something that make your face brighting. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned the hadith, that the ummah, his ummah, this is something which is for the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They will be known because of the trace or the effect of what of the wudu they did. Ghurran muhajjalin. The athar, the trace of the wudu, it will be shown in them with a brightening face because of this wudu. So this is the word wudu. This is why they said, I met وقابلت رجلا وضيء الوجه وضيء الوجه. That means his face is shining face. See, so this is the word wudu. So this is why we say it always, we use the Islamic term because it has deep meaning in that. طيب. Now let's go to Abu Huraira. We already talked about Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه before. You remember what his name, Abu Huraira? ها ايوه عبد الرحمن عبد الرحمن ابن صخر اكسل ما شاء الله يا وعبد الرحمن his name is عبد الرحمن ابن صخر الدوسي no this is سبحان الله ابو هريره he embraced Islam later, I mean. It was not from the beginning. But mashallah, the few years that he spent with the Prophet ﷺ, he reported many hadiths for us. And we already talked in detail about Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. طيب. Let's go to the explanation of the Sheikh. He said, لأمرتهم أمر. The word Amr in Arabic means what? Order. Amr. Amr ta'am, that means I order them. When said Amr, that means something that should be what? Should be done. Must. You have Amr wa Nahi. As in mentioning the hadith. Ida amartukum. When the Prophet ﷺ say order amartukum, that means you should what to respond, which is different than nahi. Naam? So amrun wa nahi. The amr, it's an order. This is why they said al amru lil ijab. When say this is amr, this is order, that means you should what respond to the best of your ability. قال عليه السلام وإذا أمرتكم بشيء ها فأتوا منه ما استطعتم. If I ordered you or I commanded you to do something or anything, then you should what? Do it for the best at the best of your ability. This is the amr. طيب. طيب. Does any word that which is it come in the form of command in the Sunnah, does mean it is must? This is why we need to know the negotiation of the ulama. Because sometimes it's the word, the command, it looks like what? It is must. But sometimes it is command, and sometimes it's encouraging to do it. Just an encouragement, you know, it's not must. Which is, we said, desirable. Something mustahab. Mustahab. طيب. How can I know when it is must or when it is desirable? You see, we know this from others, other hadith, other proofs. See? طيب. قال The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لو لا if not, as we mentioned in the meaning. And this to show you that he didn't made this command. If it were not too much. So the Prophet ﷺ, he did not make this order or this command. But from this we know that this, that means this is something which is what? Highly recommended. To the point that the Prophet ﷺ, he want to make it as what? As compulsory. To the point that he want to do it, okay, to command it, us with it. But because he always feel about the Ummah, he doesn't look put burden on them, you know, make it difficult, make it hard on his followers, so he didn't do it. He didn't say, I command you. This is if, the condition here. Because and this to show you the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We did not send you but what? A mercy to the whole world, the whole universe. And you know that in different situation, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, sometimes he want to do something, but he afraid that, you know, if he continue or if the people follow him at the time of the revelation, then it's become a command from Allah Azza wa Jal, then it will be revealed to him that it is must. And one example is Taraweeh. At-Taraweeh. You know Taraweeh, which is in Ramadan. The Prophet one night, he in Ramadan, he went out and he prayed in the masjid. The next night, some people, they saw him, so they pray with him. The third night, more people came. So everybody is telling them, we would pray with the Prophet ﷺ. Taraweeh. So the fourth night, he didn't come out with them. They waited. You know, the house is next to the... But he didn't come to them. So in the later on, they ask, no Prophet of Allah, we have been waiting for you to, you know, to pray congregation with you. He said, I know. But I didn't come because I saw what you did. And I was afraid if I continue, then it will come revelation that make it must on you, and then you will not be able to do it or keep it on. Look to the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes he want to fast. Likewise, he was traveling. He was in a journey and he was fasting. So when he was told that many people are suffering, it was hot, and they cannot, you know, continue. So he told them, break your fast. It is permitted, you know, at the time traveling journey, that you can break your fast. And you can do it later. It's Ramadan. But nobody break his fast because the Prophet ﷺ, he didn't. So what he did, he himself broke his fast to make it easy for them. Show the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is one example that he said, I wish that I make it command or compulsory in my ummah that every time they make wudu, they use miswak or siwak. But I'm afraid it will be very difficult for them. Now, طيب السواك, this is refer to not only this. This is miswak. Miswak originally is a stick from a tree called the arak. Darak. Hey. Nam? I'm not sure. I'm not expert. Yeah, subhanallah. Anyway, this is an example. So, does this mean that should be from this tree or any stick from any tree? If it can do the job of cleaning, we can use it. You can use it, no problem. Because the purpose is what? Cleaning. And this is the argument here the Sheikh also presented. Is it must that I use this to get the reward of the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that at the time of wudu, that I get the reward? Some ulama, they said, you know, this is the best. But you don't have miswak, what do you do? You can use your finger cleaning your teeth or tooth. A brush, you can use it also. Because the purpose is what? The cleaning. Cleaning. So this is the point here. But for sure, if we use the miswak, this is the better. This is the best. It always pay.
Sheikh, sorry, this to be. Sheikh, there was a video in the YouTube. Have you seen that? You know, they have researched and found the benefit of miswak. Give people in the West, particularly in the States.
Nah.
Sportsmen, non-Muslims.
Nah.
Have you not seen the video?
SubhanAllah. No, I heard about it. I heard about it. This is, you know, to show some of the miracles of the revelation of, you know. But at the same point also, I understand this and I appreciate what you said. Always, I would like to turn your attention, it's very important, to be careful for any report that come from the Western or the people regarding they discover this, you know. So some people, they think they take it as luck. Because by the time passing, okay, if the people, they said, yeah, you see, they discovered this miswak. And then another study, they came with the opposite. They said, okay, this is confusing. That's my point. So sometimes, unfortunately, also be careful from the internet, from the circulation of any material that come to you in the internet. Because sometimes there are some lies. Okay? Some lies. You know, like the picture. You know, one time they circulated, everybody, you know, there's picture that this picture was Boeing. They said, you know, picture for the tree? Yeah, the tree. Yeah, it's very famous, huh? And they said this is in Germany and it is, you know, and even the direction was toward the Kaaba. And it was circulated, many Muslims were happy with this. This is subhanAllah, look to the ayat of Allah. And later on, they discovered that it was paint. Somebody.
Yeah.
Do it, so be careful about this.
Nah. Especially nowadays, there is some British lady.
Nah.
She's discovering about Quran and about the Hadith. And it's very circulated nowadays.
Yeah, be careful. Yeah, I got what you mean.
British lady.
There's program.
Yeah.
There is program. And non-Muslim lady, she was presenting the miracles in the Quran.
Actually, this, behind them, there is some Muslims.
Yeah, but be careful. Anyway, yeah, be careful of these materials.
They are talking about they just came out about the black holes.
Anyway, let's go back to our subject here. Tayyib. قال ومن ذلك السواك قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم السواك مطهرة للفم مرضاة للرب. Siwak, mataharatun lilfam, purification for the mouth. Tayyib, marzatun lilrab, pleasing the Lord. So the Muslim, he do it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here is very important, the intention is very important. When you talk about what? Intention. Maybe some people, they make miswak or talk, but they don't have the intention that for ibadah, for pleasing Allah. Nah.
What's the meaning of miswak?
Yeah, miswak is this called miswak.
And it's part of the tree?
The stick.
Or
no, the stick. This is called miswak.
And it's called miswak.
Yes, yeah, yeah. Because the word, you see, the word miswak, it's the thing that you use for cleaning.
It's
like
for
yeah, cleaning. For siwak.
Even the brush can make things.
Yes. Not take the name, but it do the job.
It does the job.
It does the job, yes. So here, we go back to our discussion that does this mean that one should use the miswak itself, or we talk about the action? Is the reward based on the tool that we use, or the means that, or the action, the outcome? Na'am? This is different between ulama regarding this. But said some of them, they said if you are using anything to clean your mouth for the purpose of pleasing Allah, na'am, doesn't matter what the tool that you are using. Even this your, for example, a person now, when he make wudu, he has toothbrush there, and always when he make wudu, at the time of gargle, cleaning the mouth, he take this and do it. Will he get this reward? Yeah, some ulama, they said yes. Because he came, he did the action at that minute. But always we say to be in the safe side and to follow the exact sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If this stick is available or you can get it, then it's better. Then it is highly recommended. Bye. Bye. The Sheikh, he has good argument, he said. He said, does this mean, the same point that I mentioned, does this mean refers to the tool or the action? What he said? He said, if it was the tool that we are using, miswak, then it will be very difficult to tell everyone of the Ummah that he carry miswak in his pocket. So here, he said, in fact, it's more likely to refer to what? To what? To the action.
Yeah,
to the action, not the tool. طيب? نعم. طيب. We learn from this hadith many different benefits. First of all, this question. Is it, when he said, if it was not bought in my ummah, that means I wish or I will command them to do this, but I will not do it because it will be difficult for them. Now from this word, we know that that means the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he initiate hukum or ruling by himself before he get command from Allah regarding this. The question, does the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do this, or even this word when he said it because he received revelation? No. Here it show you, according to what the Sheikh said, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is no problem or no question that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes he makes certain rules, and then Allah azza wa jal either approve it or disapprove it. So if it was approved, then it's become what? Hukum. If it was not approved, then we will learn. Because Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he did not approve something, he will tell him. And there are certain examples of this. Like, for example, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi forgive at the time of Badr. You remember at the time of after the Ghazwa at Badr, the battle of Badr, and the Muslim, they gained victory over the disbelievers. So what happened? They have around 70 of those war prisoner, okay, and the Sahaba, they said, what should we do with them? So some of them, like Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, kill them. So this will be listened to those behind them. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he said, they are our relative, and inshallah may Allah guide them. And so show them mercy and forgiveness, this will attract their heart. And some they said they pay ransom for this. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went with, you know, they are paying for their freedom, or they teach some of them, you know, in a form of teaching some kids or something like this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not approve this. But he forgave, he considered this, it was considered as, as well, it should not be this way. So that even the revelation that come, it's come in very strong way, in very strong form. The point that here I would like to emphasize that sometimes the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said something, and later it will be approved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever he say is revelation. But the point here, the discussion is that can the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do something and then it will be approved, or from the beginning it is it's not? And there's, as you know, there sometimes the Quran is correcting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding certain things. Like, for example, in Abasa wa Tawalla. Abasa wa Tawalla. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has the intention that, you know, good motive for the da'wah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you see, did not approve that. He leave that blind man, طيب, and go with this argon. And you know the surah and the explanation of surah Abasa wa Tawalla. So this is another example. Anyway, the point is when he said La amarta, that I wish that I commanded. Now, طيب. قال أريد. So now in this case, this situation, there is two things. The Prophet ﷺ would like to command us to use miswak. At the same time, he doesn't want to make it must. So if it become must, and when he didn't respond to it, that means he will be committing what? Committing sin. Because he should obey the Prophet ﷺ. So now it is not must. Like, which is better now, to do it or not to do it? It's better to do it. That means it is highly recommended. And how did we know this? Because this supported by other hadith, which is encourage us to use the miswa or siwa. طيب. نعم. The Sheikh here, by the way, he is with the Sheikh bin Athameen. We are explaining from his book. When we talk about two different views, one that say that should use the miswak itself, the stick. Other they say you can use your hand or toothbrush or whatever other tool that clean the mouth. He said here it is morally strongly, you know, to show that it refers to the action and not the tool. So the Sheikh, he's with this. But he said, as we said, it is, if it, the miswak is available, then it's better. It is okay. طيب. طيب. When he said, with every ablution, does this mean only using miswak or cleaning the mouth, only limited at the time of wudu, or it's at any time? Here, okay. When he said, I command them with every ablution, right? He said, now he mentioned that this miswak, you know, should be done with every ablution. Does this mean it is limited to this time when you are doing ablution only? Or that means it is recommended at any time, but it's strongly recommended at the time of ablution? The last one.
Yes.
Okay, the last one. طيب. Will you the question at the end of the طيب. So then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مع كل وضوء. طيب. Is it before starting wudu or after he finished from wudu or during wudu? There's three possibility, right or not? لأمرتهم بالسواك مع كل وضوء. That means with every ablution. Okay, is it before you start, you go and make, you know, toothbrush or use miswak and then you start wudu? Or during, when you come to the point that you clean your mouth, you use the miswak? Or after you make wudu and you finish, then you can make the miswak? So there's three possibility. So which one the Sheikh said? The Sheikh said this hadith is general. That means you can understand any one of them. But most of the scholars, they emphasize that it should be used at the time of what? When you are cleaning your mouth. Because this is the place that you are cleaning this part of your this organ. Then you should use it when you are cleaning your mouth. طيب. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. طيب. Another point here. We mentioned that it is not limited only at the time of what? Of wudu. طيب. What other time that it is preferred or recommended to use miswak? Okay.
After waking from sleep.
Okay, when the person wake before from sleeping, he clean before reading the Quran.
If you feel you have some smell in the mouth.
Yeah, if there's smell in the mouth, anytime that you need. You see, طيب, does it always in all time if you are fasting or not fasting?
Yes.
Now, if you are fasting, is it preferable to use miswak or not to use miswak? Because this is an area of what? Of argument and debate between ulama. Naam? What's the debate? What's the basis for this debate? And this argument? Because?
Because the arak.
Naam?
The arak of the taste, the goes inside from the outer part.
Yeah.
So that is, I think, the.
Yeah, because the smell that come from the mouth as a result of fasting, which is because the stomach is empty, and it's not nice smell that's come out, or it's not that like when a person he wake up from his sleep. But in some narration that said that smell which people they don't like, it is with Allah Azza wa Jal better and more than the musk. So since Allah loves this smell, so why should you take it and clean it? This is the argument of one side. So therefore they said it's not recommended at the fasting. Other thing they said, because this may break the fast sometimes. And there's if you look and read in the madhab, there's some madhab they said you cannot or it's not right to have miswak or to do siwak or toothbrush, especially after the mid of the day. After the mid of the day. Some ulama they say. After the noon. Afternoon. Afternoon, then you should stop.
Naam? During fasting.
Yeah, at the time fasting. Yeah. That's mean when you are fasting Ramadan or any time, you can, but afternoon, then you should not use it. But the sound view regarding this, that it is recommended in all time. Siwak and cleaning, using toothbrush, whenever you need it, you can do it. As we say, before you recite the Quran, before you go to Salah, before you go to meeting, before with meet people, all are recommended at this time. Now. طيب
think Ustad, toothbrush.
Can we please keep always keep the question?
Yeah.
Don't forget, write it down so you don't forget. Now I'll ask you, Sheikh Mahidin, what was your question?
You
said, I forgot.
No, you already answered, Sheikh.
Yeah, طيب, جزاك الله خير, الحمد لله. طيب. There's other Amr ibn Rabi'ah, Amr ibn Rabi'ah, one of the Sahaba, he said, رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما لا أحصي يتسوك وهو صائم. This is an answer for those who said it is not recommended to do siwak at the time of fasting. What he said, رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. ما لا أحصي. That, you know, times that I cannot count. And he was using miswak while he was fasting. That means countless time I noticed that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم using miswak even when he is his fasting. So from this we learn that it is recommended in all time, even at the time of fasting. But be careful, especially if somebody using toothbrush and use this paste, that when he fast, some of them may go inside. But if it's just outside, he clean it and throw it away, then it's okay. It's okay. So the Sheikh said, فَالصَّوَابُ أَنْ يُسَنُّ لِلصَّائِمْ أَنْ يَتَسَوَّكْ كَمَا يُسَنُّ لَغَيْرِ بِكُلِّ وَقْتْ. It is sunnah to have siwak at any time. طيب, other question. Now the Sheikh, he present a question that in the mind of some people, and then he tried to answer it. Is it desirable, okay, recommended, that one take miswak and use it in front of the people wherever he go? You know, some people, you know, when they see some people, they, you know, cleaning his mouth and every, you know, he said, what? Especially from different cultures, right? They think it's not... Yeah, yeah. So some, is it okay to do it in front of the people or not? According to the Sheikh said, the Prophet ﷺ used to do it in front of the people, so there is no harm. But here, you see, you need to take in account the culture of the people. If they, you know, look at this action that it's not desirable or not polite, you know, then it's better to stay away of it. Okay? So it depends on the situation.
No.
Right. Because some people, they don't understand this. They don't understand that it is sunnah. They say, oh, look at this guy. He forget to clean his mouth when he wake up or at home, and now he just remember. And he just cleaning in front of everybody. You know, it depends on the style. Naam? Okay, we already finished with this. طيب, so inshallah we but you have any question about this hadith?
My question was, you answered, Sheikh, what are the other times of recommended for...
Yeah.
So we should discuss from...
Yeah, we already discussed, we said, can somebody summarize it? Huh?
During,
when you start reading the Quran, before Salah,
during wudu,
this is as it's mentioned here,
huh?
When you wake up from sleep,
When
you wake at the middle of the night,
yeah, middle of the night.
You know, to pray, also you clean, all these are recommended. طيب. طيب, الحمد لله. طيب, we already, we start with the Aqeedah. You have any question? What's your question? You said that you have a question.
I don't know, you already answered.
You forgot?
No, you already answered.
Good.
Regarding the toothpaste.
Okay. Good. This is why, my dear brothers, always take it as rule. Always. Don't ask, you know, during the session of the class. Why? Because maybe some of your question, it will come at the time when you are, you know, the explanation of the... this is very, very important. Right? Besides, sometimes it disturbs the instructor. And he forgets certain points, which is very important. Or it will take the time. The time will be over before finish or wrap the whole subject. Okay, so always leave the question at that. But also, remind you that whenever you are listening and you notice anything and you have any question, write it down. So you will not forget it, so you ask about it. طيب. Last week, we started talking about what? About some of the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal, and we gave different proofs, verses from the Quran, and we explained